5.
Submarines will always play a very important role in Indian defense posturing since India has a coastline of about 7,500 kilometers. India currently operates about 15 submarines, 13 of these are diesel-electric whereas, 2 INS Arihant and INS Chakra are nuclear-powered. A nuclear submarine is a submarine that is powered by a nuclear reactor. Very advanced technologies are used, so that the reactors are miniaturized enough to be fitted inside a submarine. The high cost of nuclear technology means that relatively few states have fielded nuclear submarines. They are China, France, Russia, United Kingdom and United States. The induction of the nuclear-powered submarine clearly indicates India's intentions in the Indian Ocean region and Southeast Asia, which has recently seen increasing assertive Chinese presence in the last few years. It will also send a strong reassuring message to Southeast Asian nations like Indonesia, Vietnam and Malaysia who want India to play a more active role in the region to counter the assertiveness of China in the area. In this video, we first look at the how INS Chakra and INS Arihant is similar to each other. Then we look at how their roles are completely different.
Number 4.
The main difference between conventional submarines and nuclear submarines is the power generation system. Nuclear submarines employ nuclear reactors for this task unlike conventional submarines, which uses diesel-electric motors. Nuclear submarines have a very big advantage over conventional submarines. Unlike conventional submarines that India operates which need to surface to charge their batteries often, sometimes as frequently as 24 hours, INS Chakra and INS Arihant can stay under as long as it wants. Their ability to stay underwater is restrained only by human endurance to stay underwater. This makes them virtually undetectable as they can loiter in the vast oceans indefinitely away from the prying eyes of enemy aircrafts or satellites.
Number 3.
Within nuclear submarines, there are nuclear-powered attack submarines, or SSNs, and those that carry ballistic missiles with nuclear warheads SSPNs. The INS Chakra is a SSN. This means that it is powered by a nuclear reactor and has conventional attack missiles. Arihant is an SSPN, and is equipped with nuclear missiles. SSPN are strategic systems, whereas SSNs are more of a tactical system. INS Chakra is geared toward engaging enemy ships and submarines. INS Arihant, on the other hand, is designed for nuclear deterrence and has the capability of nuclear strike on enemy's landmass. So INS Arihant is an underwater ballistic missile carrier and launcher, unlike Chakra, which is a fighting submarine. Let us now look how these two are configured according to their roles.
Number 2.
Project 971 submarine Akula class was first deployed by the Soviet Navy in 1986. The Indian Navy currently operates INS Chakra Akula class submarine formerly known as K-152 NERPA, which New Delhi leased from Russia starting in 2011. It was formally commissioned into Indian service later in April 2012. INS Chakra has been taken on lease from Russia for 10 years. The submarine displaces 8,140 tons and can do over 30 knots, twice the speed of any other diesel-electric submarine. It is the quietest nuclear submarine around with the 80 crew members on board. The Chakra carry conventional weapons, and are configured with 8 533mm torpedo tubes. These will be used to destroy enemy ships and submarines. Chakra will allow India to tail enemy subs across oceans, trail enemy carriers, and deter enemy subs during peacetime. During war, its role will be to destroy enemy submarines and surface warships either as a part of a carrier battle group, or operating alone as a hunter. In a recent deal reportedly worth close to $2 billion, India is set to acquire a second Akula nuclear-powered attack submarine from Russia.
Number 1.
INS Arihant is the lead ship of India's Arihant class of nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines. The 6,000-ton vessel was built under the Advanced Technology Vessel (ATV) project at the Shipbuilding Center in Visakhapatnam. INS Arihant is India's first self-developed nuclear-powered submarine. Construction of 5 more Arihant-class submarines is also planned. The vessel is powered by an 83 megawatts pressurized light water reactor with enriched uranium fuel. A land-based prototype of the reactor was first built at Kalipan and made operational in September 2006. Successful operation over a period of 3 years yielded the data that enabled the production version for Arihant. It was reported that the nuclear reactor was integrated into the hull of the ATV in January 2008. Arihant has 4 vertical launch tubes, which can carry 12, 3 per launch tube, smaller K-15 missiles or 4 larger K-4 missiles. K-15 Sagarika is a nuclear-capable submarine-launched ballistic missile with a range of 700 km. K-4 is an intermediate-range nuclear-capable submarine-launched ballistic missile under development by DRDO of India to arm the Arihant-class submarine and to complement K-15 Sagarika. The missile has an effective range of 3,500 km. Both of these missiles are currently in final testing phase. There are 6 torpedo tubes. The top 2 tubes are configured for wire-guided torpedoes and the lower 4 for self-guiding rounds. Arihant is also speculated to house BrahMos supersonic cruise missile in future, for land attack and anti-ship operation. India currently possesses the ability to launch nuclear weapons from land and air. Arihant armed with K-series missile will complete the nuclear triad with the capability to launch nukes from sea. India, unlike its neighbors, has no first use of nuclear weapons policy. In this scenario, a survivable second strike capability is must. Currently, India depends on its vast territory to conceal nuclear missiles from enemy's first strike. It also keeps few nuclear-armed aircraft like Sukhoi 30MKI for immediate action. Arihant equipped with nuclear missile will provide India with a solid second strike capability.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. Kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.